In this pattern, I want to make a little different. I do have it set up as the folded band because I do need a little part of it being folded. I'm going to be doing short rows to make a rounded shirt tail effect to both the front and the back so that it looks uniform. So anyways, in there it told me knit 12 rows, do the picot hem, and then another 12 rows. Well, it's up to you. You know, you could take a pattern and you can adjust it to whatever you want. I did, and I will do 8 rows and then short row down. Now, this is just to show you that this is short rowing one stitch each row, and I believe I did it opposite the carriage. Whether you do it opposite the carriage or on the carriage side, it's really up to you. It doesn't really matter. And this one was done every 2 stitches, or 2 stitches at the end of every row. So now you can see that the point isn't as pointy as that one. Now this is not the exact yarn that I'm using, but you would want to try it out. And this is only 40 stitches. My pattern calls for 50. So I should have done with 50 stitches just to see how it would come out. So I cast it on my 50 stitches, and I just did a plain e-wrap. I could have done waste yarn, a row of ravel cord, so that I had live stitches, and that may make the seam look a little bit better than it does with the e-wrap. But I'm just doing this to show you. So now to make this more of a subtle curve, I'm going to short row 5 stitches each row, and I'm going to do it opposite the carriage side because I want to do the automatic wrap. That way there's no holes made in the work as you're going along. Unless you want those holes, then you could just, well, I can't do it over there. So in order to do 5 stitches opposite the carriage, I need to bring 4 needles out so I could do the automatic wrap. I need to set my carriage up so that it will not knit these stitches and hold. So I knit across, and the last needle knitted, I bring forward, so now here's my 5 stitches. And it may be wise to move your claw weights up, probably ahead of time, in this case being 5 stitches each row, I would probably move them up because that's about the width of the 5 stitches. If you're only doing 1 or 2 stitches and you want that pointy effect, then you don't have to move them up so often. Last needle knitted, bring out the hold. Opposite carriage, bring 4 needles out. Last needle knitted, bring forward. Now, I would be able to do this 10 times, but then I won't have any stitches on the last row. So I'm going to do it 8 times. I did stop my counter. I took my tripper off so it doesn't add the counter up. And when I reverse, after I reverse the short row, I'll do those same 8 rows so that I can have that just that little bit straightness on the end there. Fifth one was supposed to be pulled out here. So now to reverse short row, I am just going to, opposite the carriage, I am going to bring 6 needles back, knit across. The last one knitted, I'm going to bring back to holding position. So now I'm back to the 5 again. So 2, 4, 6. Now here I only have the 5, so I'm just going to push those 5 back, knit across, and then I could either take my carriage off a hold or push these back and knit back. So now I'm at the end of the short rows, and this is where I need to knit 8 rows, and then I'm going to hang my cast on hem on the first, my cast on row, onto the hooks, knit across, and then continue working on my sweater. Now I took my claw weights and hung them on the back side just to have the weight on the sides there. And then as I am hanging my first row back on the hooks there, of course I like to pull those out to hold in position so I don't lose the any of these stitches, but being the bulky, usually these don't go that bad. Now as I'm getting down to the end here, I notice the curve here is not really that much of a curve. I may have to go with short rowing 3 stitches and working that out until I have so many left in the center, and then reverse short row. This is why it's good to sometimes fool around and just see how it's going to look before you start working on your project. But the other thing is I can see the ladders in between the stitches here, which means it's being pulled out because of the needles. I am on tension dowel 7, but this is worsted weight yarn. If I had gone to 9 or 10, it probably wouldn't pull as much. So what I'm going to do is just finish doing this. I reset my counters to 0. And then I'm going to knit up so many rows, oh, probably about 20. Let's see, what do I have to do next? 42 rows. Well, maybe I'll go to 30 rows. And then I could take this off on waist yarn. I can take it off of my garter bar and hold it on that, but again, the garter bar is going to hold it out. So I would put it on waist yarn and let it sit for a while. And this way here, I don't have to worry about redoing it. If it's too little of a curve, then yes, I will have to frog that all back. I did go ahead and knit to my 42 rows here. Move my claw weights up to the end, the up here on the top. And already I could see the curvature of this, and it is starting to look nice. So leaving it on the machine like this, but getting your weights up on the top here instead of keeping it down there, will allow the bottom part to rest. And this way here, I don't have to take it off on waist yarn or the garter bar. And I could just continue from here when I come back in a few hours.